Greetings, seekers of weird and wonderful cinema. This is Vault of the Killer Bees, the place that celebrates genre films that lie just outside the mainstream, the movies that are so bad they're good, and of course, the hidden gems. Now, our sister program, the H2O Podcast, recently delves into the legacy of H.P. Lovecraft's influence. So in honor of that most excellent episode, we're going to be taking a look at a rarely seen film adaptation of Lovecraft's The Case of Charles Dexter Ward. Unfortunately, this film fell prey to the distributor's editing scissors, and it isn't what it was originally intended to be by its director. We're speaking, of course, of 1992's The Resurrected. Now, directed by Total Recall and Alien scribe Dan O'Bannon, The Resurrected tells the story of Charles Dexter Ward, a biochemist who becomes obsessed with the life of his great-great-grandfather, Joseph Kerwin, a notorious warlock. So obsessed that he actually goes about stealing the remains of various warlocks and other occult luminaries to resurrect his evil ancestor. Now, Chris Arandon steals the show in a dual role as both Ward and Kerwin. In fact, his performance and the practical effects alone are reason enough to give this film a try. Now, don't get me wrong, the other actors give good performances, especially Jane Sibbett from Friends as Ward's long-suffering wife, Fast Times at Ridgemont High's Robert Romanus as the right-hand man, to John Terry's semi-hard-boiled private eye, who've been hired to uncover the truth about Ward's sudden change of personality. But really, the film belongs to Chris Sarandon. O'Bannon's direction in the film is good, but much like its written inspiration, the film is of two minds. At times, it's a thrilling adaptation of Lovecraft's only novel, but unfortunately, it's wrapped in the airport paperback stylings of a Lifetime movie of the week, complete with an introductory voiceover and a Lady in Peril romantic subplot. I mean, the subplot is interesting, but it's never really developed adequately in this version. It's a shame, too, because that's not the version of The Resurrected that O'Bannon turned in. In his work print called The Ancestor, there's no voiceover. The romantic subplot is really, really fleshed out, and the opening segment used a process called step printing that created a unbalanced feel of time being slowed down that really set the unnervingly ominous tone for the movie. Unfortunately, the film's producers re-edited the film using alternate shots, adding the voiceover, eliminating scenes, and even going so far as to change the film's sequencing, turning it into a film that certainly doesn't live up to O'Bannon's reputation as the director of the horror classic Return of the Living Dead. We can see here John Terry, Robert Romanus, and Jane Sibbett investigating the underground lair of Charles Dexter Ward, or is it Joseph Kerwin? And as I mentioned before, the practical effects are really, really great in this movie. It certainly doesn't shy away from the ooey, gooey red goop. And as with all of these films, especially Lovecraft adaptations, you've got to have somebody in a straitjacket or somebody in an asylum going mad. In this case, we have Chris Sarandon, and in the back you can see John Terry. And here's the bloody aftermath of Joseph Kerwin / Charles Dexter Ward's escape. Not before he gets into a bloody fight with John Terry over some essential salts of a warlock. And what movie can't be complete without a ancestral resurrection skeletal attack? Now, The Resurrected is still an enjoyable watch, and I really, really recommend you give it a look. It's just a shame that O'Bannon's full version didn't make it to the video aisle. Now, Shout Factory has released a remastered version of The Resurrected on Blu-ray with multiple commentaries and an interview with S.T. Joshi, a Lovecraft historian, that really brings some perspective to this film adaptation. It's really, really fun. Unfortunately, tragically, O'Bannon's director cut is not included in this Blu-ray version. Well, this closes the vault on this week's episode. If you enjoyed it, give it a like. Subscribe to Sci-Fi for Me's YouTube channel and turn on the notifications so you don't miss another trip into the Vault of the Killer Bees, where we celebrate the best and the worst in this weird and wonderful world of genre cinema.
Copyright 2022 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.